Good morning, everybody. I think my names are up there, and I'm happy to be here presenting on Ugandan higher education. And quite a lot of good discussion has already gone on this morning. And certainly, whatever that I'm going to present will only be what has been talked separately by the two previous speakers. The outline of my presentations are given out there. Sorry. I'll start with the introduction. I'll then provide the rationale for university community engagement. And this, of course, as we have heard, resonates well with what Gandhi envisioned for education at large, but specifically for higher education, university community engagement policy framework within the East African context, with specific reference certainly to Uganda and you specifically. And then I will come down to institutional community engagement framework, the case of Gulu University, and then I will provide some observation, conclusion, further discussions. But before I continue with my presentation, I would like to place myself within the context of this presentation, I trained over as a secondary school teacher. But then, when I went for work in the university, they decided to post me to the Department of Community Education and Extramural Studies. At that time, I could not even pronounce the words. I said, where is the classroom? No, the classroom is out there. After 3 years of being prepared, to prepare lesson plans, meet students, do psychology of children, now they're telling me the classrooms in the village. I said, I don't make sense. What kind of job have you given me in the university? So, young man, go down to your office, sit, you will understand what the job is. So, okay, fine. I'm going to, in a few days, so we are posting you to where? To Guru? I am supposed to work in Makerere University in Kampala. I said, no, your job is in Guru. You are going to man one of the regional extramural centers. What am I supposed to go and do there? Go and look for villagers to teach. What am I supposed to teach? You can teach them reading and writing. I said, I'm supposed to teach reading and writing. I'm supposed to be teaching from secondary school upward. I'm now in a university. You are telling me to go and teach reading and writing. So I got baffled. So now what do I do exactly? Say, go line up with the NGOs in the community and see how you can change life in the community. Oh, that sounds nice. Okay, let me go. Then I went and settled, I started. You start from where you know. Because there is continuing education, I quickly mobilized learners in the community. There is a public examination hall. Started teaching those people, classroom system. They come in the evening, I teach them. Some were party. They come for certificate, Cambridge certificate in London, I teach them. I organize teachers to teach them. Some are now medical doctors. Okay, so that was known. But then the community bit, they had to give me a motorbike and had to run from villages to villages trying to organize classrooms and whatever. I thought that was sufficient. So, from that then, I started taking to the concept of adult education, lifelong learning, continuing education, distance education, community university engagement. And I started talking that language, reading the literature, and I forgot about school-based learning and all that kind of thing. Then in one of our I became the head of the department eventually. I became so good that they decided to call me. Now you seem to know what you're supposed to do. Now come and run the entire country. So I moved back to Kampala and I started running the entire country. Every day I was on the road. Every day I was on the road. Mobilizing groups, visiting groups, talking to people, and then organizing other resident lecturers in those regions. And in, I got sucked into universities being responsible for communities. And then I met Barrow, brings me into all this connection. In those days, I was ranting alone. I didn't know what to do. There was the German Adult Education Association pushing the same thing. That is when I first saw Rajesh in Germany. I said, wow, that's some intervention. Colorful speech. How, what a scholar. Korea was sounding like some funny organization. Very good work, but now I'm in Korea after almost 20 years. So you can see this long history. But of course, after so much work within Makerere, and of course occupying leadership position as a head of department, as a dean, and sitting in Senate, and the people who recruited you to do certain work don't understand your work. They say, I know, it's time to move back to Gulu with a university that has its motto, community transformation. I said, yes, at least there is the word community and transformation. I think these are the people I should go and join. So since I was already senior, I joined as deputy vice chancellor. Started talking to the vice chancellor again. There was one individual ahead of me who was not understanding what I said. I said, I think the next move is to take over the whole. I therefore became vice chancellor. But of course, in yesterday's discussion again, realized that I have got another dilemma. This time is not an upward dilemma, but a downward dilemma, where everybody talks what you are saying because you are the boss, but they do other things. And this really represents the dilemma of university community engagement. Well, university community engagement shows that the university certainly has a responsibility to create knowledge. And this knowledge, as we have already got this morning, is supposed to be useful knowledge for community. Knowledge that is supposed to make life better. You know, we have this civic responsibility and to work with them. It represents an opportunity for the university to excel in addressing and changing people's life. This university community engagement. And as you have already realized, universities are not yet understanding how this relationship should be structured. Therefore, we, as people who subscribe to this idea, have a big responsibility. Now, I would like to provide the rationale that the development and adaptation of new knowledge requires sufficient dialogue and collaborative actions by all stakeholders. What does this mean? It means you must dialogue. Dialogue, as we discussed yesterday, means accepting the other person as equal and bringing their own perspective and views into addressing the problems. So universities are well positioned to engage in this process, not just as experts. Of course, about Gandhi said, universities should produce experts, but what kind of expert? Expert that contributes knowledge and resources to solve social problems. Expert that respond to community initiative or address community needs. Experts that take leadership from behind, I'd like to add that. And also, you know, mediating between the community and the knowledge production industry. Knowledge production industry. Universities are knowledge production industries. Now, in East Africa, national level higher education policies are not yet very explicit in terms of university community engagement. But as you have already realized, departments called community education and extramural studies are not new within the university. For example, the department into which I got recruited was founded by Lala Jibang in the 1950s, 1953. One of the oldest departments at Makerere University and therefore in the country. But still, the relationship with community is not yet dialogical. And what does that translate to? It means the people who design this policy, especially our universities and other tertiary institutions, are still, of course, holding that universities stand on three pillars, which is teaching, research, and outreach. The outreach, for those of us who are already in the scholarship of engagement, know it's a patronizing exercise. And we would like to move away from the universities to move away from that patronizing exercise to recognizing, just like it has been stated here, that knowledge is not only the monopoly of universities. Knowledge also resides outside the university, and that knowledge needs to be recognized. We have been talking about knowledge democracy. How can we then tap that knowledge and bring it into addressing social economic problems that are being experienced? Similarly, the review of other higher education policy frameworks in the region revealed that there are indeed policy reference to engagement. Of course, as I said, with the reference to that outreach. It doesn't matter whether you are in Rwanda, Tanzania. In Tanzania is a little better because of Nyerere. He talked the language, but I don't know how much universities in Tanzania understood Nyerere and understood Gandhi, because these two are quite similar in their philosophy. And of course, one of his sayings is that while other continents have reached the moon and they have come back, Africa is still trying to reach the villages. We are still trying to reach the villages. And that effort is still going on. So, I can bluntly state that there are no explicit national level policies addressing the specific questions of community university engagement. It's not properly stated. What we have in the books of policy is outreach. And the government has instituted a policy which they think is promoting community university engagement by requiring that all programs that have been developed should have students placement, students going out into the field and what have you. But of course we have other institutions that are promoting library research. We have Forum, we have UNESCO, we have MasterCard. All these are being trying to ensure that universities are relevant in the community. We are also connecting with other international networks, the Talawa network, the CBR network under the UNESCO chair, the K4C networks, in order to promote a better understanding of community university engagement and community-based research in East Africa. So in East Africa, member universities include those countries. All those are countries of East Africa, but we try to extend it into Eastern Africa, bringing in Ethiopia, bringing in South Sudan, bringing in Somalia, and sometimes we bring in Eritrea. At Guru University, we are institutionalizing community university engagement, ensuring that all programs have beyond trips to the community and calling it engagement by instituting what we call community engagement policy and also what we call community engagement pedagogy. There are departments who are engaged in that, the Institute of Peace and Strategic Studies, they do that. We have programs, the Community Action Research programs being implemented by the Faculty of Agriculture, and we are building on the engagement model. But still, you can see the language of outreach appearing there. So in this model, we have faculties, we have students in the middle, and then we have the communities. Now, maybe we should have put it the other way around. These are developed by my staff. Where? This is struggling with them. They reach out to the community, and from the community, informs the faculty. And the sole beneficiaries are the students. So, this arrow and this arrow are all of equal power. And this is what we call they call it student-centered outreach model. I'm telling them to change it to community engagement model. But unfortunately, they were so eager that they already published it and they don't want to change. Because the paper has already been produced around that concept. These are not my work now. They are pleasing the boss. But they don't get the correct language. Because they know once they do this, then they will get promotion. Yeah, those are my observations. We still need a national level framework. We still need to continue pushing the language. We still need to operationalize community engagement approach at university, at a national level, beyond the three pillars. Then universities, public investment dialogue, and the private sector partnerships still need to continue. The regulatory bodies need to adopt and understand that, and we'll continue the engagement with them. The experience and practice in the community are currently often focused on enhancing outreach program, and we are trying to move away from that. Of course, there is the service learning, experiential learning, though we were talking about this morning, community-led, demand-driven, rights-based innovations that are brought by the community, and universities should lead the dialogue. I would want to subvert that, say communities lead the dialogue, because at the end beneficiaries of all this knowledge production is the community, not the university. And foster stronger regional collaborations and advance to advance development in the field. Thank you very much.